Welcome to worship, friends, at Trinity Presbyterian Church. It's a pleasure to have all of you with us this morning. As some of you have noticed or have heard, there's been some changes with the new CDC guidelines. If you are vaccinated, you do not have to wear a mask, but you might still choose to wear one, and that's okay. If you are vaccinated, you can participate in singing and the responsive readings, but we also understand that there are people who, for other reasons, might choose not to do that. There's no reservations required and no assigned seating. We know that a lot of people in the congregation are vaccinated, but we also know that some people have been unable to be vaccinated or have not yet had a chance. So we ask that you be kind and compassionate with each other, that you understand that other people might be making a different choice than you are, and that you be patient in this season as we wait for everyone to be able to be safe. So if you are vaccinated, you can participate in worship just as you would have before COVID. If you are not, we ask that you keep social distancing and keep wearing a mask. We ask especially that you be patient with our children because there is not yet a vaccination available for anyone under the age of 12. So they still get to wear masks, and be kind and compassionate to them as they face doing something different than everyone else is doing. We are supposed to have a congregational meeting at the end of worship today, but our numbers are a little low in person, so Art and I will check in about quorum and we'll make sure that we're ready to go ahead with that. And we'll let you know at the close of worship what the plan is there. We still have a couple of liturgist dates available for the rest of the year. If you would like to sign up, you can see Art following worship and he can help sign you up for that. Our flower chart is up and you're welcome to sign up to give flowers for one Sunday in honor of someone or in memory of a loved one. The cost of flowers has increased to $35 a week, so please plan accordingly. And money to cover those costs can be put in Karen Sassman's mailbox in the office. She is the deacon's treasurer. There is a memorial service for Jack Wolfkeel on June 19th. We invite you to come and be part of that. If you have any questions or concerns about that, you're welcome to put those to me. Our office is closed tomorrow for Memorial Day, so you're welcome to come by, but Nicole and I will not be here, and we invite you to come by instead on Tuesday when we will be back. If you've not yet had a chance to trace your hand for the stoles for Jan Hunt, we invite you to do that. You can mail them to the church, you can email them into Nicole, and we can make those into a beautiful stole for her. There are some Meals on Wheels dates open for the summer. If you're able to help with those, Meryl would love to have you, as would all of us. You can let Meryl know and she'll get you signed up and make sure you know what you need to do. Men's Club is back to monthly breakfast meetings. All men of the church are invited to join. They meet 8:30 a.m. on the first Saturday of each month at Lums. If you have questions about that, you can ask Fred Hunt or Wayne Williams. The Deacon's Rummage Sale is June 18th and 19th, and we invite you to think about helping out with that. It's always a wonderful chance to connect people in our community with things that they need and to help people in our community to empty out their houses. So if you can help out with that, you can talk to Sandy Peoples or Karen Perzia or Cindy Williams, and they can help you find the best way to serve. The Women of Trinity are hosting a luncheon at the home of Barbara Rinker. There's more information about that in your printed bulletin. It's a chance to be outside and enjoy a wonderful time of fellowship and some delicious meals. If you need the directions, they are in your newsletter and you can get them there. The women also remind people that it's important to come out and volunteer for that rummage sale. And the women are hosting a reception on June 20th in celebration of Father's Day. So we encourage you, if you're a woman who would like to participate in any of those, to check in with Sandy Peoples, and she will help you to find the best way to serve there. If you have not yet had a chance to pay your per capita for 2021, it's $35. You're welcome to send that to the church, to give it online, or to give it using the plate during worship. Friends, let us begin our worship of the Lord this morning with our prelude.
Good morning. It's been a long time. I haven't worn a sport coat for a year and a half. And I even remembered how to tie a tie. And it came out even, first time. You don't count, Don. You wear a bow tie. You have a tie on, Windsor? Did it come out even?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, happy Memorial Day / Decoration Day. Anybody ever know it as Decoration Day? Allison, you do?
Absolutely.
You know we're dating ourselves. Because for years when I was knee-high to a grasshopper, knee pants and knickers, was always Decoration Day until Congress elected to change it to Memorial Day. So now it's Memorial Day. Okay, enough of trivia. Let's call to worship. Lift up your heads, you gates. Be lifted up, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty. The Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, you gates. Lift them up, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is he, this King of glory? The Lord Almighty. He is the King of glory. Let us call to confession. Seeing that we have a great high priest who has entered the inmost heaven, Jesus, the Son of God, let us therefore approach the throne of grace with fullest confidence, that we may receive mercy for our failures and grace to help in the hour of need. In the strength of this assurance, let us confess our sins to God. Almighty God, so many of King David's psalms show a heart out of tune, sighing, crying, and breaking with sorrow, yet still claiming to faith in you. So too, our Lord, are our hearts in Jesus Christ. You have given us what we need most. His cross makes our forgiveness possible, and his Spirit sings tunes our hearts again to sing our praises. Humbly, we beg your pardon for our sins. Eagerly, we plead your help to enthrone in our hearts David's Son, Christ Jesus, King of the universe, our Savior and Lord. And with King David, we declare our trust in your unfailing love. Amen. And now a moment for personal confession.
Friends, hear and believe the good news. Through Jesus Christ, forgiveness of sins is proclaimed to you. In Christ, we have redemption through his blood in the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace. Let us join together in our response from sanctuary. Welcome any children worshiping with us today to come forward for our time with children. Good morning, friends. It's so good to see so many of you today. I think some of you had something special on Friday. Did anyone have their last day of school on Friday? And I think some of you might have to go to school a little bit longer because different schools make different calendars. But this, it's okay. You can go back and see Mama. It's okay. This is a lot. I know. This is a special weekend. It's a weekend when we remember people who fought for our country and people who died for our country. And so it's the first weekend of the summer, right? But it's also a chance to remember people who gave up a lot so that we could have the things we have. And so today, I want you to think about what you can do to help make your neighborhood or your family a better place. Can you think about something? It might be being kind to people in your family. It might be cleaning your room. I don't know if any of you have messy rooms. There's some messy rooms at my house. It might be taking care of somebody who you know is in need. Or it might be helping to take care of people who you know who are in the armed forces. But I want you to think about today, as we get ready to celebrate people who gave their lives in service, you can do something to serve someone else. Shall we pray? Gracious God, we thank you for all of these wonderful children and for the invitation to serve no matter how old or young we are. Help us to listen for what you invite us to do, and to choose to serve you with grace. Amen. All right, friends, you can go back to worship.
The first scripture lesson today is from Isaiah chapter 6, verses 1 through 8. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple. Seraphs were in attendance above him. Each had six wings. With two they covered their faces, and with two they covered their feet, and with two they flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The pivots on the threshold shook, all the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe's me, I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said, "Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt has departed and your sin is blotted out." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?" And I said, "Here am I, send me." Thus endeth the first scripture lesson.
I invite you to listen now to our second scripture lesson from Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 12 through 17. "So then, brothers and sisters, we are debtors not to the flesh to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death all the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, 'Abba, Father,' it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, and heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him." Friends, join your hearts together with mine in prayer. Let us pray. Gracious God, we give thanks that you invite us to hear these words for us this day, to think about what you invite us to do and when we are supposed to say, "Here I am." That you invite us to remember that we have been adopted into your family, to choose a new way forward. Embolden us with your Spirit that we might move forward with grace, with dignity, and with honor. We ask these things in your Son's name. Amen. Amen. This weekend, we have the chance to celebrate what makes America great. And we have the chance to focus on the kingdom of God at the same time. It happens more often than we might expect that Trinity Sunday and Memorial Day weekend fall on the same Sunday. But I think those two are not so hard to celebrate together. Together, they both invite us to serve. Together, they both remind us of the costs. Together, they both call us to new ways of being. We are invited to join in the work of the kingdom of God that is for us. And we have the reminder that part of what makes America is the willingness of people to lay down their lives for the good of the nation and for the things that we hold dear. That's what makes it work, is people who give their lives in service. I've gotten to spend some time this weekend at the cemetery with Calvin, putting flags up for veterans, looking through graves new and old, thinking about people who have died and praying for them and for their families. He's not here this morning because he is at the Harvey's Lake American Legion doing a flag ceremony. At least I hope he is. Last time John texted me, he said that what they were really doing was trying to figure out how the cigarette vending machine worked. And I dearly hope they've moved on to better and more important things. What makes America great is that people give their lives in service. And what makes the kingdom of God work is that we all come and serve. We all come with limitations and baggage. I was never in the armed forces, but it's not hard for me to imagine that people don't show up ready to serve. My guess is people show up scruffy and scared. People show up needing training, needing attention, needing people to help them find the way forward. God meets us and makes clean what needs to be made clean. God helps us to let go of the things that need to stay behind. And God helps us to choose to, instead to move forward in brave new ways. God gives us the chance to serve with open hearts and open arms, healing that which is broken and transforming us into new people. In God's kingdom, we move beyond our limitations. We become new people as servants of God. And then we have to live our lives in new ways. It's not enough in one moment to claim God's identity. You have to keep living it every day. You have to choose to be transformed by love and grace. You have to choose to transform the world that is around you. We hear first today from Isaiah the call of the prophet. This iconic story is formative in so many lives. This week, I met with two different families to plan memorial services, and they both shared how important the song, "Here I Am," was to them. That song is based on this passage from Isaiah. It's based on the reminder that when God reaches out to us, no matter how unprepared we feel to serve, we are invited to say, "Here I am." In the story, the moment when Isaiah is invited by God to serve is that moment where God gives Isaiah perfectly clear vision of his frailties and his failings. Isaiah in that moment doesn't say, "Yes, I have got it all together. I am ready to come serve." Isaiah says, "I don't know. There's a lot of things I still don't have figured out yet." He says, "I am a man of unclean lips. I am not yet ready to come and serve. But the seraphim and the cherubim come and make him clean so that he can say yes." He wants to say yes, but he needs that moment. And then he gets to step forward. He gets to serve. God meets Isaiah where he is. And God takes away the human limitations that Isaiah has so that Isaiah can come forward and serve God as a new person, instantly transformed from who he was into who he will be, so that he can serve in new ways. This man who in this moment says, "I am a man of unclean lips," he goes on to say and write some of the deepest words of our scriptures. His words transform our lives in ways we can scarcely imagine. It is amazing to think that the thing that was his limit becomes his call and vocation. We hear as well today from Romans a reminder of what happens after that initial call. See, calling is not an invitation to a one-moment thing. Calling is an invitation to continual transformation. Paul reminds the Romans that we are not called forward so we can fall back into old patterns and limits. We are called forward so that we can live into the total nature of our calling and be transformed from who we were into who we are and who we will be. One of the greatest challenges that Paul is naming is that sometimes the moment when we are called we can see clearly the vision of the kingdom of God. But then it just slips away from us. We fall back into old patterns and choices. Life crowds in on us, and we lose sight of the vision that God has set before us. So Paul says, don't just choose in one moment. Keep choosing every day. Keep choosing every day to be children of God. It is not a one-moment transformation. It is a continual life invitation. He calls us to keep growing and pressing on in faith. You cannot just say today, here I am, Lord. You have to keep saying, how can I change, Lord? How can I keep going? How can I keep moving forward? Who do you want me to be now? The kingdom of God is an invitation to come and serve. But in preparing for that call, we are changed. And in serving, we are changing. Always asking God what more we can do so that the kingdom can be drawing nearer. If your answer is, I went to Sunday school when I was 5 and I am done now, Paul would tell you you might be missing the point. The kingdom is always pressing us to find new ways of being, to find new ways of serving. So we are called as individuals to listen for who God is inviting us to be and to try to live into that vision. And we're called as a community to do the same, to heal the things that are broken inside of us, to seek to follow as God leads us forward. My hope is that this weekend you take time to remember that you are called, that you are invited to come and serve God's kingdom. Whatever you think your limitation is, God has a plan for you. It was a man of unclean lips who wrote such dear words of scripture. Paul was a man who began his service persecuting the church. Whoever you are, whatever moment of life this is, you are invited to serve. And in that service, you are called to transform lives so that everyone who meets in our community knows who you are and what you stand for. My hope is this week you can find 3 chances to say, here I am, Lord. My guess is if you listen, God is giving you little invitations, little ways to say yes, little chances to share, little moments of good news. May you continue to trust God to lead you forward as we follow into a new way of being in this new world around us. Amen. Friends, let us sing together, My Country, 'Tis of Thee. invite you now to return to God your tithes and your offerings. You may put your offering in the plate at the back if you are here with us for in-person worship. You may mail it into the church at P.O. Box 239, Dallas, Pennsylvania, 18612. Or you can give using our online giving tool. However you give, we encourage you to give generously to support the work of Trinity Presbyterian Church and our mission and ministry in the world. Please be seated. Let us come before the Lord in prayer this day. Gracious God, this day we pray for those who mourn. We pray for Shirley and for the friends and family of Alice as they find a new way through this new wilderness. We pray for all of those who gave their lives for our country, for their families who have been left behind, for those who are mourning. Help us to hold with reverence the meaning of this weekend. We pray for those within the congregation who are sick and hurting. We ask for relief from pain for Kathy. We ask for good treatments for Debbie. Be with us and bless us throughout the season. Help us to hold fast to who you call us to be. To be firm in our love and service to you, to remember that we belong to you, and that we are invited to be your children, not to fall back into old ways of living. Be with us in this season as we love and serve. Help us to look around with Christ-like eyes, to see those who are hurting and lost, to love with compassion and kindness. We join our voices together to pray as Christ taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, go out into the world to listen for God's invitation and to say, Here I am, when you are called. May God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you this day and forevermore. Amen.